Good morning, everyone. This is Lauren Cassidy, and today I'm going to be showing the effortless crop. The effortless crop is right here, as you can see. It's a really soft, short pixie cut with longer on the top, as you can see. So if I were to pick this up right through here, you can see it's shorter, and then this top piece goes over that with some long bits. Okay, how I prep this mannequin is I used our Fulfill shampoo and condition to shampoo her, and that is a density shampoo that helps create density and thickness to the hair. And then after that, I did spray her with Fanatic 21. Fanatic 21 is a multi-purpose spray that takes out frizz as well as a great cutting tool. So I did that. Now, I worked over here on my other mannequin, and let me just lift her up. I did all the sectioning so far. So what we did is we did a oval shape right over the top of the head. So how I did that is I went 2 inches from the hairline, and how I got 2 inches is I measured 2 inches on my comb. So my comb is marked. So 2 inches is right here. I took the comb, I put it flat up against the head, and I started marking my 2 inches. And then I did a wonderful oval shape all the way back to the occipital bone, which is then a half an inch above the occipital. I feel that the oval can be a challenge section to select. So what I did is I got an oval shape and a round shape to show the students that an oval shape is more like an egg shape and a circle is definitely thicker. So we just want this oval to be really narrow. So when I place it on the head, you can see that it has a very narrow section right through here. Then what I did is I have to separate the fringe through the sides. So far, does anyone have any questions? This is where I would take questions. Who would like to have a question? Who would like to share? Blah, blah, blah. Okay, going back to my tape. So I take the front section where my fringe is, and I do a diagonal forward section to the eye socket on either side of the fringe area, going 2 inches back. And I clip it neatly out of the way so the students can see what I'm doing. And then I section the side area from the top to the side, and I do a vertical section separating then the back to the sides, and I clip that out of the way. Okay, what questions do you have? And that's it, you can cut it. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we are going to take our first section, which is our fringe. We're going to take a 1-inch section, a 1-inch vertical section, starting at my fringe area. And I am going to then pick this up. And I want this fringe to be about 2 inches. Now, however, you have to understand that this is an Erica mannequin and that she has very straight hair. So if someone has curly hair or someone has different colics, then the fringe would be a little bit different. But for this presentation, we are our mannequin has straight hair and she would look good in a fringe. So we are going to feel the head shape and pull it out at 2 inches, and we're going to drop it down to see where it's going to land. So we don't want to we want a short croppy fringe. So we want to go about 2 inches, 90 degrees from the head. It's good if I have my shears in hand. 2 inches from the head, and I cut it straight across, making sure that my section is right in the middle of my nose. Really important. Oops, excuse me. So after I've cut my fringe area, my first section, it's about 2 inches long. I drop it down, and we do have some shorter bits with some longer bits because we are bringing it out 90 degrees from the hairline. Now I'm going to be working on my right hand section. So I'm going to take another 1 inch vertical section and I'm going to bring it to the previous section, which is my first section. So I'm going to have a little bit of my first section in there. And I'm going to make sure that I'm pushing it to my first section in the middle of the nose area right here. So let me just pick up that whole section. That'd be better. Pushing it out at 90 from the head, making sure it's in the middle of my nose, which it is, and bringing it straight out at 90. That looks really good. We're going to do the same thing on the other side. Take a 1 inch section, making sure that it's straight out from the head at 90. And cutting it straight down. Okay. Now, once we get to the other sections, this is then my third section, I'm going to then take these two sections and bring it to section two, which was my previous section that I just cut. So when we cut, we first cut in the center and then to the previous and then to the previous. What questions do you have? No questions? Okay, let's take about 1 minute and do that. Wonderful. I'm glad you guys all were really successful at doing that fringe. Now we're going to work on the sides. We're going to start on our right side, and I already started cutting, but I just want to show you what I'm doing. What I did is I took the first section, and it was a diagonal back section. A diagonal what? A diagonal back. That's correct. A diagonal back section. And I used the end of my fringe as my guide, okay? So when I picked up my fringe, I'm picking up my fringe and using that as my guide. And I'm going to be, can you see everyone? Okay, I have to stand in front when I'm at my right side because my elbow has to be down and my fingers have to be pointing up. So I have to stand in front of my mannequin or my model. So if we need to change this so you can see, what we want to do is we want to take a very small section on the end of my fringe as my guide, and I want to be on base with my guide, moving out from the head, mimicking my section, which is a diagonal back section, so my fingers should be what? Diagonal. Correct. And I'm going to cut that. Then I pick it up and I mimic the section. And you're going to see that it's going to go from short to long because it's mimicking that section, which is a diagonal back. The second section, however, and the other sections after that will be straight up and down, which is what? Vertical. Correct. Vertical. So what we're going to do is we're going to use our previous section as our guide now. If you can't see, you have to move this camera so she can see because I have to be standing in the front. And that goes straight out from the head. We don't want to push it back and we don't want to pull it forward. We want to be on base, pushing it out, mimicking that head shape. So it's a 90 from the head. Not overly combing it. Lifting that section up. Now, the tendency is to go square or to dip down. That is the tendency. But we want our elbow to mimic that section, so everything has to be diagonal. You have to stand in front of your work, and it's really important that your legs are either horizontal to it. Straight up and cut. Then we're going to take our third section, Now we're still vertical. We're still standing in front of the head. Now this, our last one, our design line is vertical. So we're still standing in the front. Well, I'm gonna have to switch it, okay? This is wrong though, because of, I'm gonna have to stand over here so you can see it. So I'll move my mannequin. Now that I'm vertical, I take a small section, go vertical. Now I'm mimicking this head shape, vertical, straight up. So we can see my line of where I cut it before. Right here. And cut. Now, by the time I get to my third section, my line is more vertical. So I go from diagonal to vertical to vertical as I'm moving back. Okay? And I should get this little muffin top, or whatever they want to call it, right through here. What questions do you have? Okay? We're going to do the same thing on the other side. The only thing is on the left side, I have to stand in the back. This is very important information, because my fingers have to be pointed up and my elbow has to be pointed down. Otherwise, if my fingers are pointed down, I'm like, or up, my fingers are like this, my elbow is out, and it becomes too cumbersome. Or if I'm in the front, my elbow is up, see? So that is not conducive to the cutter's advantage. You can really hurt yourself over time. So it's really important that your body position works for you and not against you. Do you understand that? If you understand that, say yes. Yes. Okay. So we're going to do the same thing on the other side. Okay, wonderful. You can see that we got both sides done, as well as the fringe. You can see how our shape is coming alive. It is really, really graduated, shorter, obviously, on the top, longer in the back, because our fingers were elevated vertically and then went into, were elevated diagonally in the first section and then went vertical, but still lifting that hair, making this a little longer on the bottom. So you can see the really pretty graduation we're getting with this, okay? Is everyone still excited about continuing? Yes? Okay. Any questions? No? Let's move on. Now we're in the back area. The back area is sort of a fun place to be with this. What we want to do is we want to comb it all down with the fine teeth of our comb. And we're going to be moving everything up to this oval shape line. That's what we're going to be doing. And we're going to be doing it in a horizontal fashion. Now, anytime we cut horizontally, that brings in weight or length. Which one? Weight, correct. So we are going to section, we're going to start here. I'm going to start on my right. Doesn't matter which way you start, right or left, but you have to be very mindful of your work. So when we bring up this section, we want to bring it up in the back horizontally, lifting all the hair. We want to use the fine teeth of the comb and get it straight up and go straight through. So it's a one very neat section. We don't want to do this. This is what we don't want to do. See how the hair is falling out? It's a little messy. Can you see that, everybody? Yes. So instead, we want to bring it up to our line right here, our oval shaped line, and we want to mimic our fingers to that line. Okay, so if I'm over here, my fingers are mimicking that line, and my guide is my last section from the back on the top. So this is my section right here. You can see that is my guide. I have to be, my shoulders have to be right on parallel to my my line. And my elbows need to be up, not down close, because I'm creating a horizontal line. What questions do you have with that? Bringing it straight up, close to the head. Bringing it up as straight to that line where that hair lives. And I cut horizontally to my first knuckle. Why to my first knuckle? Correct, because you don't want to cut yourself inside your fingers. Absolutely. So bring it straight up, keep it nice and neat. Keep that tension. Now, I had to move a little bit because now I'm over here going to my left. So I'm shifting, but my feet are horizontal, just like my section. Move it up to where my oval line is, and I'm dropping it down. And you can see what it's creating. It's creating weight. It's also creating graduation. So we're going to continue this until we meet the other section. Okay, so we're back and I cut the whole back, but I want you to see when I pull out either section from where it lives, it should be even and the length should be the same. One shouldn't be shorter than the other, and they are perfectly even. Now, why is that? Why were they perfectly even? Who would like to share? Yes. Yes, because it's where I was standing. I was standing directly where my section was. So that does that mean I have to move from side to side as I'm cutting, or am I staying stationary? Correct, I'm moving. So you want to make sure that these shoulders are directly in front of where you're cutting. I always say it's like heart cutting. It's in the center of your heart, in the center of your body, and that's where you cut. And then if you're over here, you have to move. But I find that it's really easy if my legs and my feet are horizontal to my shape instead of leaning vertical, because when I lean, what happens? My shoulder, one goes forward and one goes back, so I could have what? A shorter side and a longer side, right? Correct. Okay? So you have to be aware of your body position when you do that. And it's beautifully done, just like it should be. Really great graduation, longer to short. Now we're gonna start cutting this off, and let me show you how to do that. We're going to comb this down, and I'll be back in just a minute. So now we're gonna show you what we're gonna do, and before we do any more cutting, we're gonna blow dry what we just did. So we are gonna use our shaping control gel with a little bit of our air dry cream, okay? Sorry about that, I forgot the words. Okay, so we're just gonna use a very small amount, about the size of a dime. We don't need to use a lot with Pureology because the products are so highly concentrated. Now you can use, instead of using the air dry cream, you can use the lightweight styling lotion as well from the Smooth Perfection line, but I don't have it right now. So I'm gonna be using this, and I think this is a very nice combination because the first product I put in my hand gives control, and the air dry cream really helps for decreased drying time as well as helping to stop any kind of frizz. So I work into my hands going downward and upward, making sure I get everything nice when I move in my front. Don't want my front to be fringy, so I get the product on my hands. You know, this is what I say. It's really good to use really good product, but it's also very important how you use the product, because you could overuse a product, or you could put the product in a certain area like this, like sometimes clients do, and get it too concentrated in one area. So after we do that, we are going to be doing a blow dry. It is a wrap dry. What? A wrap dry, exactly. How many of you do wrap dries? Show of hands. Yes, a few of you. How many have never done a wrap dry? Okay, just a couple. So let me share with you how you want to do a wrap dry. First, you need a really strong hair dryer, which you, I'm sure, all have, with a nozzle. It's very important that you use a nozzle for proper airflow. The other thing is you make sure that your dryer is on high heat. High heat dryer. Then we can either use a 9-row Denman or a 7-row Denman or even a 5-row Denman. I have my 9-row Denman with me. And I really want to make sure, I'm going to start in the back, that my airflow goes parallel with my brush, like this, as you can see. I am not tilting my brush like this. My brush is in direct correlation with my dryer. High heat and tension. What really dries hair? High heat and tension. So I'm wrapping it. Right here. So the airflow, you have to imagine the airflow like water going down a mountain. Okay, the airflow. It's not like this. Because if you go like this, you're going to get what? Frizz. Right. And you're going to wrap dry it from the right to the left. And then you're going to change it, change the direction. Change your nozzle, and then you're going to go from left to right. Now, we don't want these ends to get frizzy, so we have to acknowledge the ends. So I'm going to use the first 3 rows of my Denman and gently lift it up and dry these ends. And I'm going to do the front the exact same way. Once it's dry, I'll show you my end result. Our Denman blow dry is done, and you can see how fabulous using those 2 fabulous Pureology products, which is our Shaping Control Gel and our Air Dry Cream, gives such texture as well as smoothness to this blow dry. You know, it's really important that we use a lot of tension while we do this, and you can see the results of shiny hair even on this mannequin. Just fabulous. Okay, now on to the next. We are going to then start doing our detail work. Our first signature technique is called sketching, and this is called surface sketching. And surface sketching is when we really are working on the hairline. So the hairline in the back as well as the front. So we want to find where our line is. It's way up here. So we want to go about an inch below the perimeter line, about an inch below, and we want to use the first 3 blades of our razor. So in doing so, I want to make sure that I'm not holding my razor right out here and doing it, because I lose some what? Control. So instead, I'm going to take my razor and I'm going to pick up my section vertical, and I'm going to just sketch right like that. And I'm going to pick up another section. I'm not pulling it way out. I'm just pulling it from where it lives, picking up some of it so I can see where and the razor is a great tool. This is a fresh razor, by the way. We don't want to use old razors. If we use old razors, what happens? You get a lot of breakage. So we want to use some fresh razors. And this is what I call the scary area. So we don't want to pull it right over here. We want to pull it straight back, so we're safeguarding the hole. And we're going to do the whole surface sketching just like this. So it's going to take me a little while. And we're going to do the same thing on the other side. Now we're done with our surface sketching, and now we're going to do our regular sketching. Our regular sketching is also done with our razors. So we want to hold our razor just like so, with our pointer finger on the top of it, sort of just like pointing it, okay? And the rest of our thumb and other fingers wrapped around. So you have that control, because we're not going to be using any kind of comb, just combing the hair. And we're going to go diagonal and create some texture with our sketching. So we're going to go one way. The hair grows right now, sort of grows down and to the right. So you have to go with the flow. And this removes some of the weight. It just does minimal internal work, which I really like, especially using a fresh blade. Okay, then we're going to do the other side. So we're going to do this sketching everywhere, going from right to left and left to right, just inside. We're not going to touch the fringe area, just the sides and the back. Now I'm going to move to my blenders. I'm going to use my blenders, and I'm going to do internal feathering with my blenders. Here are my blenders, and these were just recently sharpened, so we're going to get a really nice cut on that. And with our blenders, with our internal feathering, I'm just going to pick up the hair and go down to remove once again some weight. These are some beautiful signature techniques that we have. Now, some of you may have seen these before, and that's great because it confirms what you already know. But some of you may have never seen this before. So you just want to pick it up gently and feather and remove some of the bulk. You're not removing any of the weight. How many have done this before? Great. Okay. So this is the third thing that we've done. So we've done sketching, and we've done two types of sketching. Now we're doing some blending. I want to get to my right side here. Take off some of the hair to remove some of this bulk. You know, it also depends on how much you're going to do. It depends on the hair that you're using, the hair that you have. So it depends on density of hair. Also depends on if the hair is curly or straight. You can see it has a nice short feeling. The product is already in there. I like it. I think it's looking really good. So the last thing we're going to do is edging. Edging is done with our blades. Let me get my blades. And we're going to edge out to in. Out from the outside to the inside. So when I edge, and I edge from the outside to the inside, meaning I'm at the outside of my hair going in, and I want to create some jagged edges. When I edge from out to in, I get a harsher, more structured type line. When I edge from in to out, I can edge anywhere, but in to out means I'm going in and I'm going out. I'm going in, I'm going out. That creates a softer edge. So if you're around the hairline in the back and someone says, I want a great fringe in that back, you would edge from in to out. If someone wants a very strong, structured line, then you edge from out to in. So I'm just going to do some detail work. And you can see I have some strong, what I call bitty bits, strong bitty bits. And it's really where you want to place them. This is where your creativity and your motion in your haircut comes in. And sometimes you need to pick up the hair to create that edging type of look to it. It just opens up the face. I do a lot of this kind of work. I'm sure that some of you have too. How many have used edging, right? But how many of you have actually had a name to it, right? So sometimes we don't have a name to it, and this way it gives us a name for our clients to tell them what we're doing and what techniques, instead of them going in and doing their own fringe, like they like to cut their own fringe. Sometimes that's not so good. Okay, so this is edging from out the outside to the inside. I think it looks really good. I'm not gonna overdo it because I always can do more, but this just gives you the general feel. I wanna do the top, and then I want to put some product in it, okay? Okay. We are gonna be doing our last section. So to do that, we have to take down our really pretty oval that we did not too long ago. And now we're going to be doing a 1-inch vertical section from the top. I'm gonna have to move this down since I'm a little petite. And I'm going to move my other sections out of the way. Now my other sections are wet and I'm already done with this dry section. So here's my 1-inch vertical section. And what I wanna do is, I can't get all of this in here. My fingers are not big enough. So I'm just going to section it out, cut it in half for right now. And I'm going to pull this straight out from the head, going with the head shape, which is 90 degrees from the head. Here it is. And we want to make sure that we're not going to pick up any hair from the bottom because we do not want it this short. So what we don't want to do is pick up that and use that as our guide. This is not our guide. This is a disconnected, longer area, longer section. So straight up from the head, pulling it straight out, keeping it about 6 inches in length for this mannequin, and cutting it straight out. Now I'll see how long it is to see if I like that length. That's a little too long. So I'm going to shorten it up just a little. From where it lives. Straight up from the head, 90 from the head. That looks good. It's about 5 inches. As I work my way up, I'm going to take my fingers and I'm going to have them go up, as you can see, pointed upward now. So I'm not horizontal. As I move up, straight up from the head, I want to point my fingers up diagonal. I'm gonna cut diagonal, and as I move to the front, do it diagonal. All other subsequent sections, we're gonna take another 1-inch vertical section. We're going to bring it to the center, so to the previous, and I'm going to do the exact same thing on either side. Move it straight up from the head, 90 degrees here in the back, straight up from the head, cut it straight. Then, we're on the top of the head. Our finger angle is gonna change and we're gonna be going diagonal upward, I would say. This way it will keep your fringe longer, as you can see, keeps it longer, okay? So we're gonna do that on both sides the same way. We are all blow dried with our pretty top section, which is our oval section. And we also, to blow dry this with, we are supposed to use the new volumizing mousse, but that hasn't come out yet. So I use the same two products, but I used a very small amount of these in combination, and I blew dry it with a wrap dry using my Denman brush, my dryer, heat, and tension. Now I want to do some feathering, a feathering technique to texturize this. And this is all about 5 inches. And you can see it has longer bits. This is where you put your emotion into your haircut. So what we want to do is pick up only the oval sections. And we want to feather from inside to out. It's called feathering in to out. Gives it a softer look. So if I were to feather going out to in, it would look like this. And this would give me a lot of diverse and a little bit of a harsher line, sort of like when we did our edging from out to in. But now we want to do soft feathering. So we go in and take out, in and take out, in and take out, in and take out. You get that? See that? Softer. And you don't, what you don't want to do is this, is just pick it up and just like, you know, just really quick. You want to get in there and cut that section. In there and cut it. Because you want to take out some of the inside. That's why it's called feathering and internal feathering, because internally you're taking out some of the weight on the edging of the... And we do all this, and this is where your custom work comes in. After it's blow dried and everything, it's pretty much it. So let me do some of this and get back to you. Okay, so I have seen that there is some longer bits. So I just wanted to bring the group back together and show you something that I like. I like to twist it. Something like grazing that we did with our first haircut. And, you know, twisting it and going down on it to give it soft edging or softer emotion into the haircut. So twisting it and going down on it creates different pieces, because this longer piece, you know, it's not a big area because it's not a circle. It is an oval. So it's narrower on the top going back. I like to call it an egg. It's easy. It's a great visual. And I think the more visuals we have with our classes, the better it is. And the top is not supposed to be perfect. It's okay to have a longer piece and a shorter piece, you know, wherever you think that needs to go. Yeah. I like it like this. Then what we want to do is we want to add some product. And at the very end, I wanted to add some cuticle polisher, which is awesome. This can be used on dry hair. Once again, taking a very small amount, the size of a pea, working it in my hands, working it from a cream to a serum. So your hands should look like this. And then working it into my fringe area. And you can see how everything is coming alive once you put the product in. And you can style it however you want. If you want it nice and flat, if you want it more rounded and big, it's really up to you. If you want some pieces that sort of stick out, it's really up to you. But I think she's very, very pretty. It's a great look. This effortless crop is a great look for women that want short hair but want a longer top. And also even a longer back, because you can see this isn't cut up right to here. It gives a nice fringy look with the sketching that we did. So these are all techniques that you can use on this one haircut, but in many different haircuts. So In this segment, we did the effortless crop. I'll bring over my other mannequin. So now I did two, and I did color these with Shades EQ gloss, as you can see. And one is a little, this is a little bit longer, this is a little bit shorter. This mannequin is an Ellie, and this is an Erica. So depending on what you use, you'll get different end results. Here's the back as well, as you can see. But I left the fringe longer on one that I did here, just so that in my classes, people can see it doesn't have to be exactly like this one, or exactly like this one. So depending on the texture and the density of the hair, if the hair is straight, if the hair is curly, that's really about it. So we got Modern Shag and we got Effortless Crop. I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you later.